We live in a world driven by data that offer breakthrough possibilities in research, bringing deeper understanding of ourselves and the world around us. However, the complexity and the sheer amount of data being generated is overwhelming, and all of this information is meaningless without the skills and tools to search, interpret, and contextualize it. In response, we are leveraging the power of science and data journalism to create STEM literacy through infographics, or SLI. The SLI project is a diverse group of collaborators, including several universities, schools, and informal learning environments in Colorado, Massachusetts, and Missouri. Together, we are exploring how to foster authentic context for young adults to create data-driven science infographics using readily available digital tools towards greater science and mathematical literacy. A key part of the effort was developing a set of guidelines for connecting data journalism to STEM literacy. Our guidelines point to how students can make it matter, find credibility and give credit, and show what they mean. The foundation of an effective infographic is to make personal connections. We want students to ask themselves, why should I care about this issue? In this infographic, a student explored his own experiences and choices in dealing with cauliflower ear, a wrestling-related injury. Student infographic designers need to make sense of the science, answering questions like, what does science and technology tell us about this issue? This student author used current data shown in purple and future estimates shown in blue to visualize trends in arthritis rates. In order to reach their audience, students must communicate how their topic matters to other people with questions such as, how are people affected and how many people are affected? This author represented disease and mortality rates for the three most common types of cancer caused by tobacco use. To create accurate and unbiased infographics, students need to find and select credible data, asking questions like, what are the go-to reliable sources I need to check on this topic? Through internet research, this author found and interviewed a top researcher in the field on her topic of zombie bees. A successful infographic requires students to visualize their data effectively, asking questions like, what visual and textual elements and techniques convey useful ideas about the issue? This author utilized a calendar and color coding to show tornado frequencies over a decade. Arelli researched her topic of dairy cows on the web dealing with missing data. She noticed an interesting pattern. Milk production went up over time, but the number of cows went down. She contextualized the increase in milk production with historical events and designed a visualization to incorporate the variables in the history. She decided to use bubbles to represent the amount of milk, plot the number of cows on the y-axis, and add callouts for important historical developments. In her final infographic, she reinforced the reduction in number of cows with a pictogram on the left side and added more context for the science behind one of the reasons for increased milk production, the introduction of recombinant bovine growth hormone.